It's recording, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good evening to everyone. So without wasting any time, let's move to our today's topic. So our today's topic is about coughing therapy. And today we are going to learn together on and about only the fundamentals of coughing therapy. Okay, coughing therapy is a very huge course, and we are completing this course today only a part of it. Okay, only the fundamental parts, and lots of professionals say that it's a pseudoscience, right? So let's discuss about it also. Okay, let's move to the first slide and topic. What is coughing therapy?
So can you make it full screen?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's start with what is coughing. Coughing is an ancient Chinese medicine. It's also commonly known as vacuum therapy and also suction therapy. Okay, so in ancient time, it was done by using horn in an edge like cup, and suction was created through the mouth. So what's the problem occurring that time? That the blood and germs on the skin or superficial layer directly come to the therapist's mouth. So they have the chance for the infection also if the patient have. Cupping is a mechanical, non-invasive technique. It has direct physiological effect. It completely depends upon examination and reasoning. So next, what are the definitions? As per traditional Chinese medicine.
Sir, your slide is not means changing.
It's changing, I think. Cupping is a type of this, right? You can see that?
We can see only first slide. What is cupping?
Oh, now?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, wait.
Just click on that slide play option. Maybe after that it will change after you click.
Let me check again.
No problem, sir. You can continue. You just need to, I think, change the slide manually.
Okay, wait.
Just share the screen again and you can start.
Okay. Just give me 1 minute, huh? Okay, the problem occurs actually in the full screen. Now it's visible.
Yes, sir, it's visible. You can carry on like this.
Continue with it. Okay.
Okay, sure, sir.
Okay, let's come to the definition part. What are the definitions of coughing? As per the traditional Chinese medicine, coughing is a therapy used in Chinese medicine to remove stagnation and stimulation the flow of qi, that is QI. It's called qi. As we also read on our BPT degree that qi is the energy which flow in our body. It has two poles. One is yin, another is yang. One is negative, that is yin, and another one is positive, that is yang. So as per alternative medicine, modern science, the coughing therapy is an alternative medicine technique where therapist puts special coughs of a patient's skin to treat the condition of the patient. So these are the definitions. So you can check in this image that in the ancient time, the therapist puts the horns on or above the skin to treat any of the conditions. As I mentioned that time, to use the suction pressure, they use directly through the mouth. Okay. So next, why we use cupping? Most commonly, cupping is used for relaxation, for pain relief, inflammation reduction, to improve range of motion and athletic performance, to increase blood flow, deep tissue massage, myofascial release, activation of lymphatic system, skin rejuvenation, and as well as it plays very effective role in rehabilitation goals also. So what are the difference? We listen to what most commonly, that is Hizama and cupping. There are two words that dry cupping is most commonly known as cupping and wet cupping is commonly known as Hizama. If you consider another way, the only difference is of about the language only. Cupping is modern terminology based on the treatment and Hizama is as Arabian language. So next is history. The cupping has a very huge history, so let's skip the part. Next is, before going to the screening test, that how you can perform the cupping therapy, what should the precaution should be take, lots of things are there. So as we discussed on the fundamental pattern, so I am only considering the important parts only. Okay. So next come to the classification of cupping therapy. What are the classifications? As per the technical types, the cupping is divided again into dry cupping, flash cupping, wet cupping, massage cupping. As per the power of suction related types, the cupping is light cupping, medium cupping, strong cupping, and pulsatilla cupping. Okay, it's very rarely used. Method of suction related types, again fire cupping, manual suction cupping, automatic suction cupping. Then another two types, that are added therapy related types, condition and area treated related types. Okay, then move to the classification as per the based on application. So cupping is divided in three forms. One is S, 2S and 3S. What are the things? S is, if we consider the first S, the single S is only the suction, means we apply a cuff over the skin and put the suction only. That is first S, but single S. Okay. That one is dry cupping, we can consider that. Second one is 2S. 2S means suction, then scarification. Scarification means the superficial cuts over the skin by using any blade or whatever available in surgical blades also. That is 2S. And the 3S is, 3S we refer that first is suction, then scarification, and again suction. But we followed in the weight cupping or hijama. Remember the 3 points? Commonly we use the first one is S, that is suction. We use only the suction pressure in dry cupping. The third one is 3S, that is first suction, scarification, and again suction. That means in weight cupping, we apply first suction over the target area. Then we apply the scarification by using surgical blade. Then again, we apply the suction pressure to complete the weight cupping procedure. Okay. Next, the various kind of cups are available in market. You can see that the first image you can see in ancient time, the traditional cupping method is using by using the horn cups. These are the horn cups. Okay. Nowadays, there are most commonly 4 types of cups are used. The first one and the fourth one, that both are used for the fire cupping. Okay. This one is the glass cups and this one is the bamboo cups, that is used for fire cupping. And the second one, you can see the plastic cups are used for both dry cupping and wet cupping also. And the third one is silicone cups, that most commonly we use it for the dynamic cupping purpose. Okay. So next, what are the parts of a normal cup? The first, you can see the upper part, the upper yellow part, you can see the piston. That is, through that we can control the pressure over the skin and also to release the pressure. Then the below to that part is the upper cup part, that is upper to the cup. Okay. And inside the body, this complete part is body, and inside the body you can see the red part, that is magnetic head. We can use it or remove it. And the last, which connects to the skin, that is the cup entrance part. Okay. So this one in the side, you can see that this is the pump and this is the suction tube. So the pump used to apply the pressure over the cup. Okay. And the suction tube used commonly to for the dynamic cupping by using this cup only. This tube is useful. Otherwise, it's not that much useful. Okay. So next, the screening test. The screening test is most important before starting the cupping therapy. What is screening test? Before applying cup, a test is done over the patient by applying weight cupping or dry cupping, whatever it's suitable and comfortable for the patient or not, to check the comfortability of the patient, that the cupping treatment is suitable or not for the patient. If there is any problem occur or patient feels any uncomfortable during the application, then we should not apply the cupping therapy. That the screening, the important part is, if you want to screen the patient that the cup is actually comfortable for the patient or not, you should apply over the C7 to T1 area, this area only. Okay. You can apply on this area for the screening test. So apply a dry cup on C7 and T1 area of the spine by applying suction pressure and ask the patient continuously, put it for up to 3 minutes and ask the patient continuously that how patient feels, good or bad, what is the experience of the patient, and also mark that any significant changes occurs over the skin. Okay. Next, effect of cupping. What are the effects? First is physiological effects. It helps to improve the skin's biomechanical properties, local aerobic metabolism, cellular immunity gene expression, neuroendocrine modulation, thereby reducing excess inflammation and toxin accumulations also. These are the physiological effects. Then the therapeutic effects are chronic facial adhesion and contracture. We can apply the cupping therapy also. It's much beneficial on that. Then directly we move to the part of skin reactions. When we apply the cupping therapy, we can commonly see that these kind of skin discoloration you may see after the application of cupping therapy. Okay. So now discuss the discoloration types and what it signifies. The first light red or pink color, you can see that this one is healthy skin, that is normal skin. This one, you can see that the second image, that is light red or pink coloration, which is, we can say it's normal also. After the cupping application, if it, this color is occur, then this is the normal color. Okay. So this shows the superficial stagnation and restrictions are released. Mostly it founds in the acute conditions. This is absolutely normal in the cupping therapy and most commons also in a healthy person's body. Okay. Next, the purple dark. The purple or the dark red color you can see in the third image. It means deeper stagnation released. This site may be the intense injury or old injury are present. Like example, you can take the deep bruise also. Also, we can consider it normal. There is not that much issue. The third one, purple raised. The fourth one is purple raised. And also the fifth one. Here, the thicker material generally old deposits came out of the layer of the skin. After the application of the cuff, if we found this fourth and fifth discoloration over the skin, that refers that the old deposits came out from the layer. To remove these deposits, we should apply the wet cuff. After the application of dry cuff, if we found this kind of discoloration, then we should apply the wet cuff. Okay. Then the gray discoloration. Gray discoloration, sometimes we will get a rare, very rare discoloration like gray. That you can see in the last image. Last image you can see. Sometimes we found this kind of discoloration. This signifies the smoke. Usually also we can found this kind of discoloration on firefighter and craftsmen. Another one is there is no discoloration. Sometimes we can see after the application of cupping, there is no discoloration occur. That means the poor blood circulation over the skin. That means that time we can see the healthy normal skin normal skin color over the patient. So that means due to poor circulation, we found this kind of problem. Okay. So the normal is this one. This one is most common normal patients. If we apply any cuff over a patient, then we normally found the second discoloration. Okay. Lots of times we found blisters also. You can see on the second row, second image, this one. These are called blisters over the skin. Then what is that? Blister is just like bubbles which pop up when fluid collects under the pocket of the top layer. It can be filled with pus cell or few times also with the blood also. To prevent from blisters, remember the thing, we should apply light pressure or suction when applying the cuff over the skin. Each time of the application should be within 3 to 5 minutes. Each application of cupping, remember the one thing, each application of cupping should be between 3 to 5 minutes and should be the 1/5 of the cup pressure. Means if you divide the cup in fifth segment, just see, if you divide the cup in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the 1/5 part, that means only this part, up to that part, only the suction to be applied. Okay, so that the we can prevent the blisters. The next, as I mentioned always, before applying the cup, we should perform the screening test so that if the discolorations occur within the pink and light red, as I mentioned on that area, pink and light red, then we can do dry cupping. But if the color we found, that purple, deep red or black, that time we should definitely perform the wet cupping. Okay, so that one is much beneficial for the patient. Then few avoidable areas are there for the wet cupping only, not for the dry cupping. Before application of the wet cupping, there are some avoidable areas, the areas we should avoid on our body. Okay, first one is carotid artery. Second one is armpit under the axilla, because the axillary artery are passes through that. Okay, third one is radial artery. Fourth one is posterior tibial artery. Fifth one is groin area, because the iliac artery are there. Okay, so next come to the, these are the areas. Okay, we should avoid the cupping. On the first is carotid artery, second is armpit, third is radial artery, fourth one is posterior tibial artery, and the fifth one is groin area. Okay, next come to the indications of cupping. These are the few indications. Any kind of musculoskeletal conditions like cervical spondylosis, frozen shoulder, neck stiffness, tennis elbow, low back pain, soft tissue injury, muscle spasm, heel pain, shin pain, calf, and few medical diseases, like also we can apply on abdominal pain, insomnia, headache, cerebrovascular diseases, flu, cold also. The few contraindications are fracture of bone in treatment area, we should avoid the ulcers, deep vein thrombosis, heart disease, hemophilic patient, unconscious patient. In these conditions, we should avoid the cupping therapy. Okay. Then few lots of side effects are also there in cupping therapy, like redness of skin. As I mentioned, that it's normal, but we can consider it as a side effect. Okay. So the first side effect is redness of skin. Few times fluid accumulate under the skin, swelling, bruises, mild discomforts, skin irritations. These are few side effects of the cupping therapy. Okay, so these are the fundamentals. Okay, if you want to continue, lots of things are there in cupping. It's a huge, very huge course actually. Okay, so these are the most basic fundamentals of cupping therapy. Next come to what is, why it's commonly known as pseudoscience. We most commonly listened from lots of professionals that it's a pseudoscience. What is the real truth and why lots of professionals are saying that it's a pseudoscience? I have listened from lots of professionals that it's valueless, it is effectiveless. But it's why few times we listened it, as we are physiotherapists, we are applying continuously the cupping therapy also, and we got good results also, but still we are listening these things. Why? Definitely it works. Okay, it works miraculously, I can say, if we can use it on particular area, on specific condition wise. Okay, but after that it's called pseudoscience because due to less research on cupping therapy, due to very less amount of research on cupping therapy, lots of professionals consider it on pseudoscience part. Another thing is, there is not certain findings on it that how it works on our body properly scientifically. As like the acupressure therapy, that is in the scientific way, we can't found the exact way of working or the effectiveness of cupping therapy in our body. Mostly the problem is in hijama or wet cupping. Due to lack of evidence on that particular part, lots of professionals are saying that it's a pseudoscience. In cupping or hijama, therapist claims that it can remove unspecified toxins from our body, and also cupping improves the blood flow. Okay, these two points have no scientific that much evidence. So the professional claims that it is pseudoscience. But if we treat particularly, it's really much helpful, and we can use it as an assistive treatment on lots of conditions like pain relief or increasing the circulation, and it's really much helpful in rehab goals. To achieve the rehab goals, it's much more helpful than anything else. We have applied it, and really, it's much magically helpful. But due to lack of evidence, we can consider, as a physiotherapist, we are considering it as pseudoscience. Okay. So these are all the fundamental things I have discussed. For any doubt and clarifications or any doubt clearance, you can directly message me on this given number. We are running with basic and advanced online courses in very few amount of this cupping therapy. If you want, you can join directly by messaging me in this number. You can note down it. Okay. Then I have an announcement. Dr. Bilal, may I announce this thing?
Yes, sure.
Okay. So we are going to start in the next Sunday a very huge mega session on biomechanics and musculoskeletal conditions with lots of professional expert and professional research persons. The basic part of it is continuous on our YouTube channel. It's completely free, and it will taken by the young professionals. Okay, but this part is advanced parts. As you can see, the topics also, few topics I have mentioned. There are more than 20 plus topics will be covered in 1 month, and these topics will be taken by the expert professionals only. Okay, in 5 weeks it will continue every Sunday. So if you and we are taking very negligible price for that. If you want, you can join also by messaging me directly on this number, or you can contact to Dr. Bilal also. Okay, he is the associate part with it. Okay, thank you, Dr. Bilal, and thank you all of you for listening.
And sir, we have some topics, I think.
Okay.
Questions for you.
Okay, fine. Tell
sir,
me.
You can stop the recording, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. So first question.